your like tactics for dealing with kids when they not, like freak out? I was a nanny for 12 to 14 years. I probably blacked out a couple times, but
one of the things that I think is the best times, especially with distance learning, my patient, I have extreme patience during distance learning.
Yeah.
Together,
yeah,
safely,
yeah,
quarantining. Jump for the paint.
I do like the ones that are like just a big smile on them already. Mm-hmm. Like there's one that I wanted to get my boyfriend for Christmas to get was Macaulay Culkin's like mouth and his hands from that scene from Home Alone, and he loves like Home Alone is his favorite Christmas movie. Yeah, I want to get him
now. Oh my god, good times with that one. Glad you know about that.
Youngins.
That's like there's so many products from 2020 that would not never made sense before COVID.
Yeah,
like the mask and stuff. Or like, have you seen the ones where you have like a little clamp to eat, so it like opens up? And you see your hand, you just like open and close the mask.
Yeah.
What?
So it would come in handy though, because there's been a couple times where I go to the, and I hardly ever like, I'm not really a coffee drinker, but like if I am. I know if I have like a 2 p.m. type coffee thing, like I need like my big day like energy round. But yeah, I'm like, hey, we can bet 10 every day to get up and go, and like I'm good, but I also am very strict with that time. What time do you go to bed then? I'm for sure in bed by 9 or 9:30, and I'm obviously not always asleep.
My goal is to be asleep by like 10:30 at the absolutest.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get to bed at 8:30 and just go to bed.
Yeah, the nanny jobs get you get used to, and you're like, yeah, I just get up early now.
Yeah, I'm not like I'm used to not waking up early, but like when my boyfriend first moved in, I'd wake up and he'd be like, and he, just with his niceties, I love him, man, but he'd be like, how'd you sleep? I'd be fine. I'm like, if you're like a genuine question to ask me, I am fully here to answer it. But like, I don't need these like, how would you sleep? How do you feel? Like,
but most women would kill for that.
Oh, I mean, I'm like,
ask about
trauma.
Your feelings. That would be so amazing.
I'm like the total opposite. I'm like,
no, don't you dare. And then like on the weekends, he's like, sorry, I won't talk to you for like an hour. And I'm like, what's the weekend? It's different. But again, I don't need these niceties.
He's got it good then. He doesn't have to
love it.
Right. Oh my god, it's 6:05.
Yeah. Oh, you snuck up on me.
Wow, I got a good crew. You know how to work with talent, okay?
Okay.
Now you're taking the picture.
When did we start live?
At the math jump out the window story? Well, hi there. Welcome. Welcome. No, this is not a Bob Ross video. Salute to him, though. This is a modern age 2021 video. My name is Charisse Mahal, and I'm with Paint Your Pet Portraits. Today I'm going to talk relaxing like this, and you're going to watch me paint a picture of a dog. Sound fun? All right, well, let's get started. First, I want to introduce my friend Titan. He's my muse today. Do we have Titan here? He'll be back. Okay. First, you know what, before he comes back, I want to do our sponsor for today. We got the Minnesota Boxer Rescue. Here he comes. Oh, here's Titan. Come on up. Come on up, buddy. Come here. Okay. All right. Let's start off. Get my muse ready. Give him a bone. Going to have the runs later, but it's working. All right. This event is sponsored by Minnesota Boxer Rescue. Minnesota Boxer Rescue, let me tell you, is a foster-based dog rescue run by volunteers and your donations. They are dedicated to rescuing boxers, providing needed bedding, and finding them a new home. Dogs like Coleman, our featured dog today, right here, on the left, that's Coleman. Coleman just celebrated a one-year anniversary in the rescue. He had cancer and has had two surgeries to remove as much of the tumor as possible, but he is a loving dog looking for a retirement home without stairs and someone who will be home to keep him company most of the time. Please share Coleman's story so we can find his retirement home and consider making a donation to Minnesota Boxer Rescue through the website, so we can help more dogs like Coleman. Look at him. Oh, he's so cute. I want him. Maybe Clayton will get along with him. Well, thanks, MN Boxer Rescue, for sponsoring us tonight. All right, well, let's get to it. So, right now, I'm working on this whole background thing. You can tell, like, the vibrant colors. So, my style is chunk, just like lots of chunkies, and kind of Van Gogh, Monet-ish. Oh, he dropped his bone. Okay. Okay. My muse is Titan. Okay. And we're going to do this picture. And I'm just thinking of what I should do up here. Let me ask my crew. You guys, what do you think the color should be here? I mean, you guys choose. What do you think? Orange. We're looking at your comments live. Oh my God, there's a million. We have a million comments. I didn't realize this would be so popular. They said some more yellow. Okay. Okay, we're going to do some more yellow then. So I got some pre-mixed colors here. I love vibrant colors, let me tell you. I think every dog has like an aura. Okay. It's got a little money looking, so we're going to... Just rinse it off. I'm not too into muddy waters. Okay. So we're going to do yellow. I'm going to do yellow because Titan is blue. You got to pick like an orange or yellow for part of the background so the main vent pops out nice. So I'm out of yellow. So I'm gonna get some more yellow. Tyson, so I was saying dogs have, I think they have like an aura, you know, like how people have auras, like colors. I can't see colors, but I can kind of feel like, is that, if you have a favorite color, that's probably your aura. Mine is purple for calming, and then yellow for like a lot of energy. And that kind of reflects who I am, you know, just like the big shifts in energy. Oh my God. It could be a lot. But I think animals have it too. They have, like, I think Titan, if you can see, he's obviously gray is his go-to color. But I see blue in there. And, okay, it's pretty obvious. He's a blue-nosed pit bull, but that's their blue nose for a reason. They have blue mixed in with gray somehow. Like, kind of cool. Okay, so we're rolling, okay? We got some bright colors to make that blue and gray pop, people. Okay, now I'm going to pull back from the yellow. It's getting like really intense, okay? I'm going to pull back. I'm going to balance this thing out with something else. Let's see. We could swirl in the green again. This is where I need your vote. What color should we finish it off with? Okay, my agents are checking the comments. And what do we have?
Well, I did have some propellers in that color, but a little delayed, so.
Well, what did they say?
I think she was referring to the aura color from earlier.
Well, the aura one, yeah.
Maybe a little green in the aura. I don't know. I like that teal, too.
The teal? We can wrap the teal back in there. So, over the years, I've been painting since I was 13. And it was actually for, okay, can you be quiet over there? I'm trying to tell you my life story. It's okay, you can hear it well. I was 13, and it was for English class. And they're like, yeah, read this book and just do something, a project about it. I was like, okay. And I read, it was that Hopper guy. You guys know that artist, Edward Hopper or something? I don't know. Somebody tell me later. But I was inspired by him, and I just did this picture of a lighthouse. Oh, kind of like this one I've got going on. I don't just paint pets. I also paint nature. Cool, right? And yeah, that's how I got started, 13. And then I had years of dormancy. Not painting, so it's doing other things. But painting's always been like a journey for me, you know? A lot of people. I think everybody should just create something, you know? Even if it's like an email. You know, writing an email, writing. Whatever you need to do to be creative in your life, like, do it. It's kind of scary, though, to create. I don't know. But you just do one little thing at a time and boom, you're creating rainbows on the internet. What else? Oh, I bet you're wondering, like, what is paint your pet portraits? Well, it is what it is. I paint portraits of people's pets. I've done probably 20 so far since the launch a couple years ago, and now we're relaunching. And we're doing more of a influencer Bob Ross kind of thing. We're doing these monthly live stream events where it's going to be painting and conversation and just coziness. I think we're going to put a crackly fire back there next time, too. It'll be pretty good. Okay, let's finish it up. And then we're going to get to the heart of it, which is Titan. And I'm just real tentative about that green. Okay, I'm going to do it. You can always, the thing about acrylic is you can wait 1 minute and your mistake will dry and then you can just cover it up. It's really nice like that. you can tell I'm not like a form person so much. I'm more, it's about the colors. But I try to capture the essence. You can see the outlines are very dog-like and like the photograph. But the colors, it's going to be a mix of their natural fur color and like some fun colors. So we're going to work with some gray and some other ones. And I think I'll just slap this magenta on here. I'm going to do it. Oh my God. Oh, that was thrilling. Now we're closing it on the background. When I meet clients or paint their pet, I always ask, like, well, what's their personality like, you know? If they're like a sad dog, I'd probably paint. No, I'd probably still paint rainbow colors. You know, no dog is really sad. Maybe a dog like Coleman from Minnesota Boxer Rescue, he really needs somebody to take him in. A retirement home would be so perfect. Get that magenta going. Yeah, I always ask, like, what's their personality like, you know? And that helps me when I paint. So you want to capture their spirit. And Titan is definitely what he is. He's Titan. He's like high energy. He's super strong, powerful animal. Are you wondering when I'm ever going to finish that up? Okay. He's like such a happy guy. He's got a great origin story. We'll get into that. And he's like got a lot of spunk. He's like super bouncy and he's got a ton of energy. It's okay, I can say shit. It's fine. It's fine. Okay. Now I'm gonna check the sides because I like to make sure the painting goes to the sides too. So when people hang it, they get the chunkiness. I don't like when my clients frame. They don't need to frame it because it's got these side panels going, and it's so globby that it looks super cool. I like it. I've always done that. It's a trademark, okay? Don't copy me. Just kidding. And then I just check for like a couple wood spots. Okay. And it's actually okay if there's white spots because I don't know, it's not really about being perfect anymore, is it? It's just about getting the big picture. Okay, so I've got some space here. And I'm just gonna smear that with my finger. There you go. Who cares? Okay. Background done. Okay, no pressure. Here's the hard part. No, it's the fun part. It's fun. Don't be scared, Justice Mahalo. Alright, I'm gonna move to smaller brushes. We're gonna zoom in a little bit and get some more detail. Okay. And when I create a new art, I always try to get some good music going, good vibes. That helps you get into, you know, your creation. Kind of like channeling something, giving you a direction. Okay. See this? It's slightly smaller. We're going into some smaller fields. Strokes aren't going to be as big. Okay, don't be intimidated, you got this, Mahal. I think I'll start with like the ears and then work my way in to the special part, the eyeballs. If you tune in long enough, you might see the finale, which is the eyes. I know. Just buckle up, okay? Okay, so let's look at the ears. So I always start with kind of light to dark, then otherwise do the reverse and it's like, oh, it's too much, smear, so you do light to dark. And his ear is like, It's not really a pink, it's kind of really light gray, but a light gray pink maybe. Doesn't matter. It's good. We're good. I'm gonna mix that up. Yeah. Got that going. His inner ear color. So tricky. Get that inner ear color now. Alright. And then kind of looks like is anything gonna happen here? Kind of looks, but it does. You just go with it. Go with it. Mixing on the spot here. Are we still streaming?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God. Yeah, it's my first live stream. It's so crazy. Just gotta just make sure. It's my first live stream as a fine artist. It's going fine. It's all right. We're good. What are you guys doing tonight, you know, besides having me on the background? Oh, yeah? Playing cards? Did you care? Okay. Okay. And there's a little bit of highlight in there. But again, it really doesn't have to be perfect. Somehow it does come together. And it's kind of, okay, it's lighter here. Okay. And up there a little bit. Boom, inner ear. Dunzos. Okay. Now, I'm going to go to a little darker, and then the outline of the ear is going to be the darkest there. Let's see. We're gonna pull some gray. Oh, I gotta concentrate for this. It's been a while since I've painted. So it's kinda, it's like new again to me. It's like a little scary. Every time you create something, it's like vulnerability kind of. It's just a little scary. But it's worth it. It always turns out fine. Really fun. Okay, we're adding in some grays. I remember when I got Titan, it was the grayest week of my life. Literally, it was so cloudy. I just remember it was gray like him. And it was a good week. That was from Animal Humane Society in Golden Valley. That was so much fun. And he is actually a stray from Alabama. Okay, I gotta focus. Focus up with this one. And here's coming along. All right. Now it's now we gotta just add a little bit of blue because he's a blue nose pitbull. Shout out to blue noses. This is hard for me to do this, because I gotta keep it moving. But if there's some part where you guys, if you hate it, I can go back and it again. Okay? Don't worry about it. We're good. I think it was good, though. Titan is busy over there, chewing on the phone. Okay. And this will get a little too natural colored, so I'll probably end up going back and like adding blues and stuff. But we'll keep going and keep going. And you guys probably won't see like I'll probably get like maybe half of it done. It's just how it is, you know. I'm not guaranteeing like gonna be done today. But I was trying to get you through as much as possible. Just want to make that little tip pop a little bit more. Oh, Titan's gone. Yeah, get that blue in there. Well, it's a pretty quarantine safe night you and me that we're doing tonight. Just you, me, and the canvas and the art. Alright, so I'm going to keep it moving. That looks okay. I might come back and do a couple of whatevers, but we'll just keep it going. And it kind of doesn't look like, is it ever going to be anything? Like, there's so many chunks. But somehow, when you wrap it together, it's kind of Monet-ish, and the strokes come together. Don't tell me, you got this. You should. All right, now, oh God, we're gonna do the other ear. This one I might get a little bolder. I love Titan's anatomy. He's got the up ear and the floppy. Like, so cute, love that guy. Where is he? He is shy, he's so shy. But yeah, he's such a unique dog. I found him at the Humane Society and it was just some day, my other dog, Nola, had passed away. She was a red-nosed pit bull. And God, I was heartbroken, it was so hard. She just died suddenly, she's 9 and yeah, I was heartbroken. It was only 2 months later that my dad, he just had to stop by the Humane Society because we were so dog sick. You know, just when your dog passes away, oh, it hurts so bad. And, he messaged me. He's like, hey, I found this dog, Allison. She was a red-nosed pit bull. And I was like, oh my God, I was at a cabin and I got so excited. I was like, yes, we're gonna have another dog. And I went there on the way back from the cabin to try and find this Allison dog. And she had already been taken. And I was like, no! So let's just walk around. And so we walked around, my best friend was with me. She's like, let's go, I wanna go home. I was like, there's dog, girl, let's just walk around. And I was walking and walking, and I didn't see any of them. Like, I didn't connect with any of them. And even they're even like puppies. And I was like, shmeh. And I walked around, did the lap. They had the dog, everyone was up in their kennel. And then I saw this doggy. Oh, so cute. Can you see that? We saw this guy and he was sitting just like a gentleman, and I was like, oh my God, I have to meet him. So I just had to meet him, and we went to the meeting room, the little conjugal visit room thing that they make you go into. And he jumped all over me and he's giving me kisses and he just loves kisses, you know. And I just screamed out, I love him, I love him. And yep, $500 later, only, I got a new dog, Christmas, people. I loved adopting. I'd never done that before. And that's why I really like MN Rescue, Boxer Rescue, because they're all about cute boxers with their little smudgies and like rescuing all types of boxers. So I'm definitely a boxer pitbull gal. So we're on to the other ear. Couple stories later, and think we should add some gray in there. This ear, I'm actually doing the reverse. I'm starting with the light colors and like the colorful blue, and then working this gray in there. Yeah, whatever. Does that look like an ear to you? Anyone out there? Alright. Okay. So, he's looking a little more like a pitbull. So yeah, then Titan, I took him home, and he's such a well-behaved dog, and he has such a cool story. He literally came from Alabama, and dog, he got rescued with a bunch of other dogs. Animal Humane Society, I'm sure MN Boxer Rescue does it too. They just take trucks and just go pick up dogs that need help. Otherwise, who knows where they'd be. All right, now we're gonna, we're gonna go into this section here. Let's check in. Let's just check in with this upper ear, though. I just want to see if I can add a little more, I don't know, brightness to it. We'll get back to it. It looks a little muddy to me, but I think I'll probably end up redoing it. But it doesn't matter. All right. Let's move along. Okay, just shake it out. Gotta loosen up. Let's start with his light colors. Oh, we're going to need some more light. And beautiful gray. Here's my little gray bear. Oh man, this is, and then we got that beautiful, he's got such cute coloring, he's got this like white streak, and then white here, and then gray, he looks like he's always wearing his gray suit, he's pretty darn cute. Come along, it's going to be pitbull. I think now's a good time to do a little sponsor break. So if you're just tuning in, we're painting Titan, and we're also talking about Minnesota Boxer Rescue, and we're trying to get this cute guy adopted. See that fella? That's Coleman. He's from Minnesota Boxer Rescue. A little bit more about Coleman. Let's talk about him. So Coleman is a foster from Minnesota Boxer Rescue, and that place is run all volunteers and running on donations, and they're dedicated to rescuing boxers, of course, and they provide all the vetting and finding them a new home. And dogs like Coleman over here, who he's been there for a year. See, that's a year too long. Let's get him out of the rescue. Let's get him into his new home. And Coleman's had a journey all of himself. He's had cancer and two surgeries, but he's this loving dog, and he's looking for a retirement home. And if you're a retirement home watching this, consider adopting Coleman. And you can go to mnboxerrescue.rescue.groups or rescue groups. Oh,
rescue groups.
mnboxerrescue.rescuegroups.org. Check out Coleman. All right, back to Titan. So I like to step away, just like step away for a second, then look at it again. Like, okay. Oh yeah, I'm feeling this ear. That's cool. I like that. Oh man. I haven't done a vape pain like this in a while. This is going to take some experimenting. I haven't painted in a while, and I've got to work through this here. This side is whiter. Turn the music up. I took this picture today, the fresh pic. I try to let the painting, you know, try to not think too much, you know, like just in let. There he is! Tiny! Come on! Say hi to your millions of fans! There we go. There's my muse. Sit, buddy. Titan, sit. See ya? Just like the ear. He's my live nude model. He's very comfortable. Oh, guys. All right. Where's your next? It's getting this long side of the face going. This is going to be like the light side. Now we're learning. How is that going to come together? It's so crazy. But it does somehow. 10 hours later. Not as easy as it looks, trust me. Some days it flows, and some days it's just hard work. It's just hard, you know? But you just keep trying it, you know? You just keep trying. It always turns out. It does always turn out. No, that's too good. Are you guys watching us with your pets right now? You should get, grab your pet. Grab your pet and start looking, watching. Well, my week was, it was fun, but hard, you know? It's just, like, a lot. So I have Paint Your Pets, and I also have a kids band, and a kids TV show, oops, and a podcast. And I just don't know how it works, but it's a lot of work, and it's amazing. But, you know, pressure's on. It's relaxing to paint. So I'm looking forward to the weekend, too. Okay. All right, Titan. Let's work in his grades. You don't want to get, like, too, oh, my God, blue, 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 and you forget, like, oh, yeah, he's a gray dog. I forgot. Oops. And there's his eyeball. Can you come later? I always do the eyeballs last. Something, it's the hardest thing. And if you do the eyeballs, like, and there, you work really hard at them, and then they're off center, you have to white over, and then redo it again. It's like, you really want to make sure the eyeballs are where you want. And right now, Titans look really wide set, but in this picture, they're really wide set. Like, he has his googly eyes. That's why I love him. I love all of his little... That's why he's fun to paint. It's his second thing, people. I'm gonna need some more white in here. Huh, sluggers? Shout out to my crew, Aaron and Idania, my agents and social media team. They're crushing it, their first artist, eccentric art artist they're working with. They're doing an amazing job. Oh, well, I accidentally picked up a little bit of yellow there. Maybe that part of the sea had a little bit of yellow on it. Because there is yellow light around there, so it would make sense. It's just a smidge, though, you know? Oh, God! This is really scary! What do you guys think? Do you like that? Good thing the guys came over, so I don't like it. Okay, the face is coming along. Now this part, his little furrow area, it's got a little darker. I gotta focus on this here. I don't know, it's hard to just look at something and paint it. I don't know. I kind of take credit for some paintings, but I kind of don't. It's just, like, creativity is something you channel, and it just comes out. Like, how did I do it? Not that it's this masterpiece yet, but it's cool. You know, everybody's got, like, something to bring to the world, like it's creativity. And I realized when I just decided to paint my dog for no reason, Noah, that I'm like, man, people might like this. I should probably make this into some sort of business or something. And yeah, I found that people do love getting their pets painted. It's cool. It's like have it on your wall and to have your pet memorialized, especially if, you know, they pass away, you can always remember them by vibrant picture that brings out their spirit. So I guess I was just bored one day and I painted my dog, and then I was like, you know, I'm gonna see if other people like need me to paint their dog. Or cat. I paint cats, okay? No discrimination against cats. They're wild. They're like totally wild animals, which makes them intriguing, you know? Like, if you pet them, then when are they gonna start biting you? I mean, kind of having a little fear in your own household. Yeah, like a little dangerous. I would love not being able to sleep at night because my bitch could get caught up in any moment. So I definitely paint cats. And they always give me attitude. Like every single cat, like the picture's there, it's just a picture, but I can feel the cat's resistance when I'm trying to capture it on the painting. And so I can redo. You can't try to get me. I have yet to paint like an exotic animal. To me, like a horse would be exotic. I love horses. Oh my God. I would love to paint a horse. So if you're watching, you have some horses, get in touch with us. We are Paint Your Pet Portraits. You can go to paintyourpetportraits.com, see my portfolio, and get you set up. Get your pet painted, okay? Let's check in on Titan here. His face is starting to come along. It looks like a blocky-headed pit bull. That's awesome. Call him blockhead. Got this part right here. I think it's going to be gray, medium gray. Not too dark. Okay. And you step back and you kind of, okay, that could be something. Look at that. And that always looks really good, that just white there. Once you put those eyeballs in, though, it all ties together somehow. It's kind of cool. Yeah, this is my first painting, like, being watched by the whole world. It's kind of freaky. It's from Mahal Media. It's my parent company. And they have a green screen studio / art studio, fine art studio. So it's an international fine art studio, and have a ton of people and help, thank God, to help run this baby. But that's where we're painting from, if you're wondering. I've just been teasing, like, oh, is she going to start painting? Oh, no, she's going to start telling stories again. I get 2 hours to fill, okay? Where are we at with that? Okay. We have 1 hour and 10 minutes left. We're going on a journey. We should probably get the whole, the dark side of the space done. Yeah, let's do it. The Garden of Love. The Garden of Love. I like listening to world music. Ever heard of it? It's just music from not America. Not top 40s. Not top 40s, y'all. You know, I never, Justin B did out, or Katy Perry did, or whoever, Carly B, whoever. Never, I'm not a big top 40s. I mean, Bruno Mars, come on. Duh. Okay. But I'm more into, like, world music. You guys should check out world music. Just look it up. We got a city communication. I'm so sorry. I went rogue there. That was a lot. I didn't warn you. You can just put a smidge of green in there. My garden of love. So yeah, world music's pretty awesome. you don't even have to like travel really. You just, I don't know, you just go there when you listen to world music. I really like it. I like telling people about it. My roommate is always listening to her, like, Latino, like, reggaeton, and it's like, oh, and, like, Christmas music from, you know, that you hear every year, and I just cringe, but hey, she puts up with my music, so it all works out. Well, let's move in across the face here. I want to switch up. We got like the blue, you know, and the gray. We'll keep going with the gray. Maybe like some purple a little bit. I don't know yet. I just don't even know. It's unknown. Well, let's add some purple in case you wanna. It's okay. Can we see stats? Like, who's watching? Anybody yet?
I don't know if we can see stats. I have not been able to.
I mean, like, how many hundreds of thousands? Oh, here comes my muse. Hey, Tim. Come here, buddy. Go up there. There you go. Look at the world. Go to bed. There you go. Peng has lots of tricks. Obviously, he knows go to bed. Yes. And he knows high five. Should we do it? High five. He's probably coming off here. High five. Peyton. High five. Oh, he's trying. Shake. High five. Okay. We're having fun here. Yeah. Man. That's that painting. Okay, we're getting the purple. Working that, I think. So we've got what I like to do here. Touch that up over here. This one, some paints are like just kind of syrupy and translucent, so you gotta put a couple layers on. It's just the way this magenta rolls. It's cool. It's fine. We'll go with it. So I think I'm just gonna make like a new color. Here, check out the palette. Wow. That really pops on our HD camera. Cool. So I'm gonna make like a blue purple. It's too dark. There we go. It's gotta be some variety and some drama, a change. Like one side is one way and the other side is the other way. A little switch up. And then I'm going to need to make some more. I love s'mores. It sounds like I said s'more and then I thought of s'more, so. I love s'more popcorn. Okay. Focus up. Let's make a little more light gray. We need more light and more light gray. Quick shout out to Evan, Boxer Rescue, for sponsored today. It's awesome that it's sponsored. Especially by a legit company. That's, yeah, exactly what it says, rescue boxers. I love boxers. I love how their shape, their faces, smushy mouth, and their big eyes, their beady eyes. Oh my gosh, so cute. If I had a second dog, it'd be another pity, and then a third dog would be a boxer. I'm just gonna be real. I'm a pitbull girl for life. But boxers are definitely up there. Yeah, if you guys, like, that are watching, post a picture of your dog, or specifically if you have a boxer, we'd love that. Or, you know, if you don't have a boxer and after watching this you really want one, you should probably rescue Coleman from the Minnesota Boxer Rescue. You guys, I wonder what he's doing right now.
I don't know how he's coming out then, for sure.
He probably is sitting having his tongue out, yeah, I think so. All right, let's get back to painting. Yeah, you know, like, I'm feeling fear right now. It's just like, whoa. Kind of scary to paint, you know, in front of people. There's like four people here, including Tefton, watching, and it's just like, you know, that's life though. It's taking risks and trying things and seeing what happens and painting dogs and trying not to worry too much. If you don't know what's in there, just don't do it now. Just in here. Try to honor the lights and darks. See, I'm getting too cautious. I really need to loosen up. Loosen up, you know? Just, it's cool. It's cool. The whole area looks like what, you know, except for the eyeballs. Don't see those eyeballs yet. Alright, I got this new purple blue. Tighten sniffing around. Oh no, I made that gray. Yeah, it's just painting, you know, mistakes, and you have to backslide and reconfigure this. You accidentally run your brush through, like, the black through the yellow, and then you, blah, no! Just gotta redo it. It's okay. Hi, geez, what are you doing, huh? Okay, I'm mixing this. Looks gray. Let's see. Kind of just looks the same. Okay, let me just read the same one, fine, so. Let's put some highlights in there, huh? Some bright blue, or what? If you can't tell it from Minnesota, and I bet you're wondering, does she really talk like that? Mm-hmm. Yeah, kind of. I get it from my mom. Brush. Oh my god, it's been terrorizing me. Just unmuddy it.
Terminal Tight is really a pink dog, so I almost went pink there for a second. He loves all colors, but try to explain me. This item kind of all over the place. This is reckless. Just throwing stuff everywhere. Not as excited with this item was on this side. A spresh! Back when I was fresher. Some wrinkles. If you have a pitbull, you gotta have wrinkles in there. Oh, this is messed up. This is. And your life looks darker gray. So we gotta go a little darker. That's okay. I think this is where I struggle the most when I paint is like right now. Like I need a break. You know, but you gotta keep going though. Some days you just gotta keep going. This to me is head. I'm gonna fix that later. Yeah. Head there. When you paint, you know, sometimes, like, I lose the dog's, you don't wanna lose the dog's, like, face. So I made his face a little wider. And you wanna make it, I want it to be, like, a little narrower. And then I'll fix that later. The idea is to try to keep it moving. Usually I get stuck, but then I'm a recovering perfectionist. So I bet, you know, if you like art and creating, you're probably a perfectionist too, right? Anybody in the studio perfectionist?
I should be with my writing, but I am not.
Well, that's good.
Oh, maybe that's
good. Yeah.
Because then you put it out and you're like, oh, man, I should change that.
Yeah, what's that shit like in there?
Right? I'm like, oh, it was great. I loved it until I, like, put it out there.
Alright. Mm-hmm. Alright, I'm having to undo up here, so I'm gonna switch down to here. So I'm just not feeling the area for some reason. We'll just switch it out. Maybe I'll switch back to a bigger brush. So I'm getting too, like, in my head. These sound fun. It's a journey. Now you're like, kind of fighting against yourself or your nice gray coat. Mm-hmm. mix up some more gray. This is pretty fast considering, like, some images you're wondering, like, how long do these take? And small ones, like that, those are probably going to take, when I first started, like, 15 to 20 hours. Just because you're just learning and starting something. And now I try to aim for, like, 7 to 10. And this one we're at, what time did I start that? Like 4:30, 5:30, 6:30, 2.5 hours. So I even get through this, that's pretty damn good. I'm kind of remotivated. Just to prove my self-critic wrong, like maybe I can, but it's not about how fast you get it done, you know. It's definitely about the quality. Faye keeps coming in and out. Buddy! Come on, show everyone your true form. Go to bed. Bed. Yes, yes, yes. Sit. Good boy. Shake. Yes, good boy. What do you think of your painting so far? Does it look like you? Need a little work? Okay. He's critic. So yeah, determining what are you gonna be, the collar? And no, I'm not. I'm not, bro. Okay. I like the collar, I like his look there, but I just don't feel like doing it today. When I paint your pet, yes, I will absolutely. Titan! It's your big break, come on! You know, if I was a gentleman. When I paint other people's pets, though, I usually put the collar in. Because it's definitely a part of their look. But today I just felt, I don't know, a little busy. It's okay, it's okay. Somehow this is going to turn into an animal. He's crying in here, jeez. Somebody say something. You know, this is my first time doing this, and I don't know why I did this for myself, but I'm kind of having fun, though. That 1,000 or 2,000 people watching, probably 10,000, my guess. I mean, like, on the low end. Right? Who wouldn't want to, like, spend their Friday night watching someone paint and talk in a Minnesota accent? But yeah, I mean, it's my first time doing it. And, you know, hopefully you're having fun, but I'm kind of having fun. I think Tidy's having fun. I think in life, like, you shouldn't really do anything for other people. I mean, yeah, you should, like, you should do good things for people and care about what they think a little. But you should really do things for yourself. Like, don't worry if, like, if there's only 10,000 people tonight instead of 1,000,000, like I was thinking, I hope there is probably, but if there's only 10,000, well, me and my team had fun. At least I did. At least I did. Somebody did, so. Probably worth it then. Alright, I'm gonna purify this white.
Titan is, this one's coming out a lot more pointillism-like. It's like less defined, you know, like that one, who was that one artist? Was it Manning? No, the pointillism guy. He made more. It was a different one. It was even more, like, I think it came after it. Well, fans, if you know, it's that he made that park one with all the, you should look that up.
Yeah.
I can, I go between, I don't know, the art just comes out like, I just go between like a Manet to a Monet, the Van Gogh.
And then yeah. Van Gogh is on here.
Do you like that inventor of pointillism?
I just destroyed my nails.
Good thing I'm going to the salon anyways tomorrow, so who cares? Oh, I'm looking forward to that.
This is, I still don't know how to pronounce it.
Oh, George, oh, Jorge Serrat. I think that's how you say it, Serrat. Yeah, he had that pointillism painting, and that paint, it was huge painting and became really famous.
Oh yeah, like with all the people in the park in their umbrellas.
Something a little bit done for us today. And trying to be less like perfectionistic and more just getting like a fun painting going. I don't really care about the bottom part so much. I love his shoulders, they're so cute. They just, like, I don't know, they're just so adorable. He's just so cute. When I paint the pet, I fall in love with the pet, too. It takes, each pet takes me on a journey, even though the pet isn't there, like, I don't paint pets live, but I look at their picture for hours, or like several of their pictures that the owner sends me, and I really feel like the pet from far away takes me on a journey. It's so weird. Like I love when I get to meet the pet. Alright, we're gonna get going, combing through. We'll make it, we'll come back to it if we want. We'll probably have to add some, unnatural highlights, as in some of this going on here, huh? I think this is a really light part, so it should probably have maybe some of that. That yellow, purple wearing yellow. Maybe. Okay, it's too late. I'm doing it. Okay, I totally feel like Bob Ross right there. It's like, oh. It is fun, like, really being in the moment and, like, watching the color hit the canvas. This one's, like, pretty gay pride-ish, I'm not gonna lie. It's got a lot of good rainbow. But that's how it came out, and it's beautiful, so I love it. I can always go back and change it.
But we're doing good. Their first event, you know, it's like, huh, good, good. What if Bob Ross ever messed up? If he's like, oh no, no, we're gonna have to do that, redo that.
What if the man who was like,
is that a new
thing? It's just a happy accident.
What?
Is that him?
Oh. He's
like, it's just a happy accident.
I don't know for sure if it was him or
not. My modern version of it's just a happy accident is just, it's.
It's.
And the normal, my process too is like, you have to step away, like this, I might redo this tomorrow, like I don't know. But I usually never paint for more than 3 hours at a time. Cause then you just get like, really zoned, or like, you gotta step away, get some coffee, come back, or just be done for the day. Stuff like that, like, you just, oh, keep going. See right there, looked away. And I look at it again. Oh, you gotta step back too. Like, okay, turning into something. Okay. Yes. Definitely turning into something. There's some things I feel like want to change, but let's just keep moving. Okay. Alright, we got just a little bit more time. I'm sure they want to see me finish that damn face finally. So this part all dried because I went down here, so I gotta redo it. It's fine. I'm really gonna try to let go and like just get this fucking part done. Oops, sorry, I swore. Hopefully our sponsors are mad. We're learning. You know, I tell our sponsors that, oh yeah, sometimes you swear, but it's not too bad. If it's, we learn our demographic is like kids and family and stuff, because that's when we can, you know, I can do it. Okay, I like that. That flows, like wrinkles. I love it. How come in dogs, we love like the more wrinkles, the better? And like humans, wrinkles are bad. Does anyone ever think of that? Weird. Okay. And when I create, you know, that negative voice is still, it bugs me, you know? It's just like, oh, this isn't turning out really well, like everyone's gonna hate it. Like, just, I really still struggle with that. You know, it's not all Bob Ross and happy rainbows, like, creating. That's why I have to take breaks, you know, and step back. And when you're creating, you have to be really good to yourself. And just be like, at least you're trying, you know? That's what I'm going through mentally, just like, just still doing it and having fun and not worrying what people think too much. Maybe they're enjoying the conversation, not really paying attention to the painting. Could be whatever, but most people aren't like as critical of you as you are. So, trying to like be good to myself when I paint. Alright, so we just have one kind of dark part right here. The Sir Titan's back. Go to your bed.
times I've accidentally got paint on him. It just goes everywhere. I think I'll do a dark gray right here because I've just got a lot of blue going on and like it's blue enough. Yeah, I'm definitely going to go to the salon tomorrow. Get some paint out of my nails. I like painting it out of though. Ah, not feeling that area right now. Like learning and painting is like, I don't know, you might get stuck in certain areas and you're just like, that is not flowing. And that means you just supposed to like keep moving, you know? Cool artist thoughts. Messier your hair gets, the better too. Hopefully mine's pretty messy. Alright, you ready to do the white? Let's do it. I love this white streak. It's so cute. He has the coolest markings, you know? How much of our dogs do we just appreciate the markings? They're just such a big part of who they are. I like just like chunks, you know, like, and that one, it doesn't do that at the top, so I'm gonna, that one got a little stray. Yeah, for now, sorry.
Oh, look at him. So cute. He's gonna plug himself. This is probably the fastest I've gone through painting before, so bear with me if it's a little rough.
Charming pun. Oh my god, I didn't even mean to say that. Cool. Okay, I'm going to use that again. That was funny. The artist self-deprecation and the
right, we're always running out of that light.
I think this is a good time for our final break. We have an amazing sponsor. So great for first episode of recording. That's awesome. And our first sponsor is Minnesota Boxer Rescue. They are based out of Minnesota, Minneapolis, Minnesota area, and they rescue boxers. And they love what they do. They're all made of volunteers and operate on donations from you. And they provide vet care, and they help them find new homes. Simple as that. And I think we gotta show Coleman one more time. Seven sees who we're really pushing for tonight.
Oh, look here, little bandana.
That's Coleman right there. He is 9 years old that year. He looks like a sweet guy. I love boxers. They're wide set eyes and their smushy faces and their tongues. My roommate has a bulldog. They remind me of boxers because they have the short snout and then their tongue always like falls out because their mouth is too short or something. So that's why we love dogs, because they're variables on the fur and the features. That's why I love painting them. Well, let's see what we're playing at here. Painting Titan. We've got some good things going on here. Alright, well, let's finish the snout. And next time maybe we'll finalize them, you know? Maybe we'll get to the eyes. We'll see. All right, so. Oh yeah, we're gonna add some more white. Let's add some white. I use free product placement for Dick Blix. Use Blix. Nice stuff. I like the paint to be nice and thick. My style of painting, you use a lot of paint. So yeah, we love that just chunkiness. Not all about the cheap, thin paints. I don't know if I could be an oil painter. I think I would try it just to like have the experience. But I hear oil painting, it just never fries. Like, I don't know if a painting, an artist like me would be a good fit. I mean, look at this, it's totally chunked. So yeah, I like the option of, oh, you messed up. Okay, let's try this again. Yeah. All right. Just little by little, you know, and then you get it. Titan, what are you doing over there? Oh, I'm biting his nails. It's hot. Okay. Let's do some grapes. Oh, he's running out. New grain. Have an update on the mixing palette. Palette. Okay. And just got a medium gray to the dark gray. Oh, that's really dark. Alright, and we are, let's move, let's go fast, let's do it, come on, fast, come on. Okay. Okay. Okay, I'm just, come on, just do it, Mahal, come on, come on, come on. Noses are funny to do. They're just, every nose is different. Oh my god. We're not climbing for the noses. It gets real dark right here. My style is definitely not about fast or like slow and accurate. It's trying to be a little bit faster. Let's fill in. Dark spot right here. He's got like white here and then only on this side, which is so cute. I love it. Just gonna skip over here. It's not all. Okay. Yeah, a little cartoony. I'm gonna go back to the nose. Just see what's going on there. And this is a really fast rendition. It'd be fun if we should post this, like the video, and then do like a fast forward. That'd be kind of badass. Yeah, let's do that. And then kind of good though. It doesn't have any room. Alright. Wrapping up, we're almost done. Trying to add a little dimension to her nose. The natural light was
was lighter on this side a little bit. And then the nostrils, he's got such big nostrils. Oh, he's sleeping over there. Can you guys see him? Oh, he loves relaxing. He's just a relaxer. So, Anne, how many pets do you have at your place? I keep hearing new ones every time.
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I have two cats.
Oh, that's right. And one is Egyptian. My social media agent, the people, social media person, has an Egyptian cat with one ear clip because...
Yeah, that's how they marked that he was fixed because he was on the compound where my son was stationed. And they'd vet there. And so if the cat hung out, then they'd take him, give him their shots, and fix him and
snip their ears. Oh, poor guy.
I'm very close.
That's different. Imagine if we did that in America. Oh my god, people would go apeshit. Well, we do kind of do that. We sniff their we sniff other parts. We can get sniff a beaver out. Titan has a tattoo. He's tatted up. And that's what they do to dogs now, I guess, is they tattoo them.
Yeah, my dog has like a green stripe on the belly.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. My friend's dog has a tattoo. It's like numbers though. But the dog was from, I don't know how old he is now, but he was from another state, like a southern state or something, and he got transferred up here and they adopted him, but he's got like, I think a 6-digit number tattoo. Like on the inside of his
intricate.
Intricate. I know. I can't get people still for that long. for like 45 minutes and I was like, oh god, this is, I can't sit still for that long.
It's just hard for people to tell me the numbers.
I know. And like they're obviously not big, they're very small, but he's also a very strong dog always.
And then Titan's got little bitties. You know where the whiskers go? Like little whisker holes.
What are they called?
Gritty paint fumes. Whisker holes? With pores, maybe? Come on, you have to admit, you guys don't, no one knows what they're called. They're so cute. I'm running into a little bit of a predicament. I've got dried up hair. Titan's making snoring noises or something. Titan's nose in this picture like really is pronounced. So I might shave it down a little bit. Just a little plastic surgery on here. It's like this is the right size, but when you do it on a painting sometimes you just, it looks different than the photo, like it just, so you just take some creative liberties, you know, but in the end it's going to look like your pet, for sure. I painted plants too. I love plants. Oh my god. Painting a plant is like so satisfying. It's so much fun. So if you're a plant mom like me, I'm 50, don't judge me. Go ahead and judge me. I don't care. And you love plants too. Even if you have just one orchid, I could paint your orchid for you. And then you can put the painting of your orchid up on the wall behind your orchid and just be weird at all. I think so.
Yeah, you just gotta own it. Own it.
Plants have feelings too.
Oh my god, plants totally have feelings.
I can read my plants' auras too. Like, they need to be watered. I mean, they physically just go like, ugh. But you can feel their, oh, I'm struggling, man. I need some water. Just read them. We're getting there. We're getting there. Oh, and that little chin helps. Yeah, if no one's looking smooth, so we're gonna save it. Wondering when are we gonna get those eyes? Well, you might have to check in next month for our next painting. Or I might, if you don't finish painting tonight, you might finish enough, or I might be on to another painting. It might be a current commission. Who knows? It might be a parrot. You'll have to find out. We have monthly ones. When's our next monthly painting? Yeah. Valentine's one or something? I'm trying to make this like less round. Looking round. Let's put that nose and see what's going on with the nose. You checking in? Towards the end of the event, we're so glad you're here. I hope you found us. Great. Happy Friday. I'm Charisse Mahal with Paint Your Pet Studios. I'm here with the crew, and we're wrapping up a very fun first event, premiere of Paint Your Pet Portraits, baby. Woo! I'm painting live from our studio, Fine Art Studio. We're an international studio. And we paint people's pets, simple as that, plants and exotic animals too. And we also host these monthly painting events featuring yours truly, my dog Titan over there. And today we're doing a little painting of Titan, just a real quick one, just
2 hours is what we're going to get done. And I might go back and change it. I might keep it. Who cares? That's looking pretty good, pretty good. Maybe, I have a feeling people want to see the eyes. So his eyes are golden, kind of golden brown. So, I haven't mixed the colors for the eyes yet. I think we'll finish, let's finish the nose since it's kind of in the whole blue nose thing. Got kind of that blue in there. Oh, my mom, blue. Noses have always been kind of tricky for me. Like, it's just, they just are so chaotic. Like, what? There's just so much going on. Every nose is so different. Every breed, all the breeds are so different. Like, Titan's nose is just completely different from a boxer's nose. Or a pug's nose. I have yet to paint a pug's nose, but that would be really cute. I'd be so precious. Okay, so all of that, I'm going to paint over that. He's got real big nostrils in this one. So my paint's drying up. So I like about acrylics. They dry fast. Sometimes I do, it's called a retard, paint retarder, and it slows the drying process down. And sometimes I need to do that. But this one I don't mind, I don't need it. Tiny is really crapping out on me. sleeping on the job over there, not even in the same position. How can they paint you like that, buddy? Okay, so we're gonna finish this right here. I just wanted to trim his face a little bit, so we'll add yellow there.
Oh my god, the eyes! Okay, you can do this.
We got this.
Oh my god, it's gonna be eyes in that mood. Eyes, man, I can't rush this, but, it's just like so anticlimactic to get this point, and now the eyes. I'm gonna mix up gold. Gold is brown. That's pretty cool. And for just kind of what I do for eyes is I make like a real light shade, a medium, and then kind of the dark. And then there's always, I have freckles in them. They have just many different little things going on. I love eyes. When you, do you ever stare into your pet's eyes? They're just, looks like Saturn, and there's so many things going on. Freckles of light and things that make it just really cool. I love seeing them. Alright.
Titan's got very big pupils. He's always got pupils, like dilated pupils. So he's got very small irises. And then this part I gotta be careful and not just smear everything. That would be hard. His eyes are gonna be like Mom's here in the studio. That's in the hall. One of my favorite parts is having my parents come down and watch the progress, and it's fun to like celebrate the pet as they become painted. What I really have to concentrate on is no filler conversation happening here. Oh, I love this guy. Man, I wonder what Coleman's doing right now. We're tuning in at the very end here. We're wrapping up. I'm painting of Titan, my dog, Luna's pitbull. Coming together. This is just a quick and fast painting. It's been a fun, quick little trip. Got these fun. Whoop, here's one. Got these fun eyes. Dark. the pressure is. And I'll probably spend an hour to 2 hours usually on this stuff, but I'm just going to give you something to take home. And before I do the finishing touches, next time maybe start a new painting. We're going to do this monthly from our international studio based in Bloomington, Minnesota. And if you're hooked on the Paint Your Pet brand, and you want your pet painted, guess what, I can do it. And I could do it internationally for you here, or like shoot it out to the whole universe. You can have everybody watch me paint your pet. It'd be pretty cool. So yeah, if you're wondering how do I do that, well, you just go to our website, paintyourpetportraits.com, and get your commission going. And I could paint your pet in front of the whole world right here. And thank you to our amazing sponsors, Minnesota Boxer Rescue. We hope Coleman gets rescued, gets into a new home, like this weekend. Can't wait. Cannot wait to see what that guy's up to next week, what new home he'll be in. And we'll see you next time. Titan. He's already off the job. We'll see you next time. And thanks for tuning in.